Hey citizens, welcome back. Today we're addressing something crucial, optimizing your Star Citizen settings to significantly enhance your flight experience. Although the default settings might visually look impressive, they often result in a sluggish and imprecise flying experience while also failing to clearly display vital information. Let me start by quickly showing you a comparison. First, a short flight sequence using the default settings. Notice how the ship shakes and stutters with the camera zooming in and out erratically. Next, observe the same sequence with the optimized settings we'll configure together today. Now everything is calm. The annoying shaking and inappropriate camera movements are gone, allowing you to fully focus on flying. First up, let's improve your camera controls. Disable vibration, cinematic cameras, and camera spring movement. Turning these off gives your external camera a stable and straightforward view, helping you maintain better orientation and control. The hints and control hints settings are great for newcomers, providing helpful guidance as you learn. Once you're familiar with basic controls, though, turn these off to declutter your HUD and improve visibility. The auto slowdown on landing gear deployment setting can be problematic. I strongly recommend turning it off. When enabled, it automatically reduces your ship's speed upon gear deployment, which may seem helpful but often causes crashes due to unexpected slowing. I prefer complete manual speed control to ensure smooth and precise landings. Regarding decoupled mode, this largely depends on your flying style and controls. If you're flying with mouse and keyboard, learning decoupled mode is highly beneficial, offering greater maneuverability. As a joystick user, I personally prefer the coupled mode for smoother handling, but both modes are fully viable. Let's talk about ESP, Enhanced Stick Precision. For joystick or HOTAS users, keep ESP enabled at all times and set ESP strength to 1.00 with dampening curvature at 0.00 for optimal aiming precision. Mouse users might prefer ESP disabled for improved accuracy, especially in fast-paced dogfights. Gravity compensation should typically remain enabled as it automatically counters gravity effects during atmospheric flight, offering smoother controls. You can disable it for an added challenge, though I wouldn't recommend this for a combat scenario. Next, disable both G-Safe and Boost G-Safe. These settings limit your maneuverability under high G-force conditions, something undesirable during intense dogfights. Keeping them off provides maximum agility and responsiveness. Cruise mode activation has minimal current impact, but I suggest leaving it off, activating cruise mode manually via hotkey when required. Also, disable Space Brake Uses Boost. This ensures that braking doesn't automatically drain your boost energy unnecessarily. Manual control over boost energy is essential for precise flight management. Turn off the speed limiter to maintain manual control over your maximum speed. Automatic speed limits can hinder your responsiveness and control during critical maneuvers. Deactivate proximity assist. While potentially helpful during landing sequences, it automatically reduces your speed near obstacles, which can severely hamper your combat effectiveness and precision flying around tight spaces or asteroid fields. To enhance your HUD clarity, activate all options under Advanced HUD Information. More displayed data means better informed decisions in combat. Ensure the velocity indicator, TVI, is enabled. It accurately displays your actual flight trajectory, essential for precision flying. 4. Turret ESP. Leave it disabled if using a mouse. However, make sure to familiarize yourself with turret-specific key bindings. They greatly improve accuracy and control. Activate precision mode lines to visually represent the effective area of your aim assist, aiding in precise targeting. Staggered fire should be bound but usually kept off unless required by specific weapon configurations, such as mixed ballistic energy setups. Disable both single pip and fading pip. Clearly visible, multiple aiming pips are necessary if your weapons have differing projectile velocities, greatly aiding targeting accuracy. Turn off missile count loop to avoid confusion during high stress combat situations, as missile counts resetting unexpectedly can cost you crucial seconds. Enable target arrow and pin overflow to keep crucial target data clearly visible, significantly boosting situational awareness. Disable zoom on target to manually maintain your preferred field of view without sudden unwanted zoom ins. Also, turn off automatic camera movements and the pilot look ahead feature to avoid distracting camera shifts during focused combat moments. Keep hold to exit vehicle active to prevent accidentally exiting your ship, and enable show party names for easier coordination and team visibility. For optimal graphics performance, consider using upscaling methods such as DLSS for NVIDIA GPUs, FSR for AMD, or CIG's TST as a neutral alternative. These methods can significantly boost FPS, though DLSS might slightly blur radar and HUD text. Regarding quality presets, always test the very high setting first. It sometimes provides better performance than the high setting due to optimized asset loading. Set scattered object distance to low, significantly improving FPS without noticeable visual loss. Water simulation can be visually pleasing but is resource intensive. Set to high only if your rig comfortably supports it, otherwise disable it completely. Test terrain tessellation settings between low and high in mountainous regions, choosing based on your performance results. Screen space shadows enhance visuals greatly at high settings, but consider disabling them for increased frame rates. Turn planet volumetric clouds on medium for a notable FPS boost, despite their visual appeal. Adjust your field of view, FOV, according to your monitor and personal preference. Wider FOV enhances peripheral vision at the expense of slight distortion. Always disable motion blur for clear, sharp visuals during motion, and activate VSync only if screen tearing becomes noticeable and bothersome. Set sharpening to 100% and turn off visual distractions such as film grain, chromatic aberration, and the session information QR code. For best performance without sacrificing much visual quality, prioritize high textures and shadows while keeping other settings lower. And there you have it, citizens. Your flight controls and overall experience should now feel noticeably smoother and more precise with these adjusted settings. If you found this guide helpful, please hit like, subscribe for more Star Citizen tips, and let me know in the comments if you have further suggestions or other favorite settings. Thanks for tuning in, fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.